He's 51 today, but we'll say he's 47 because you know, Toby. There's nothing more I can say. And finally, she's 27 today, a Norwich's finest export, besides mustard, of course. And see if you can guess who this is.
Cathy Dennis. I'll just do my impression of Cathy Staff. Here's Angela Rippon in the news. Sorry.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Monday, March the 25th. The government says it may spend billions on...
3 minutes past eight. Here's Keith and Zoe.
And it feels like that this morning. Hey, but we've been warmed up. Cathy Dennis is in the house! Knocked on this lady's front door a little while ago. It wasn't for the deli.
No, it wasn't.
Down your doorstep. Hey, looking in the old papers, it's full of Oscar stuff, you know. Hey, do you know at the Oscars, they have people called seat fillers?
Who wouldn't have just there to fill
in their places? No, what happens is, you know when people go and pick up their awards? Well, somebody, ABC TV, it says here, which broadcasts the ceremony, insists there must be no empty seats seen in the auditorium during the course of it. And this 57-year-old woman here is one of those seat filler persons. She says... various rules to be obeyed as you're doing it is that you must sort of face the audience as you're moving down the seats so you don't stick your bum in stars' faces.
I never knew that. But the thing is, what about when they cut away to the winners and it shows their husband and then there's always a gap?
Yeah, well, there's always that gap. But anybody has to sort of like go
if
and give an award. Yeah, all these pensioners and people rush in, you know, to sort of like fill those seats in their glitter stuff. It's not me, I'm not bonkers, they're bonkers. And just a very quick one, Bob Shields is in Los Angeles. He writes in the Scottish Daily Record. It's nice to review the sort of regional papers, isn't it? He says, you need a pass just to get to the office that issues passes. This is true. Yeah, a gold badge will let you mingle with the stars. An orange badge puts you behind a rope to watch the folks who've got gold badges. A green badge means you can sit in the marquee and watch the folk with orange badges on closed circuit TV. And it says he's got a black badge. He said, I hope it's just a little bit of rust on it, and when he brushes it up, it will be a gold badge. Did you find anything interesting quickly?
I thought this was quite interesting. The story about Sarah Cook, who's 13, marrying the Turkish 18-year-old, and they've just decided to make a 4-episode drama out of it, which is going to be shown in May.
Oh, didn't take long, did it, till the networks got onto that one.
That's incredible. Well, talking about movies, Toy Story opened last week to rave reviews, in fact, the weekend. But it has also caused a bit of a mystery, because staff in a shop in Newcastle discovered a Buzz Lightyear doll, right? He's one of the characters from the film, with a difference. Because when he talks, you see this doll, but when you press this button, and listen very carefully. Okay. You can hear that? Now, you're not imagining things. This Buzz Lightyear doll is speaking Italian. Now, that may not seem strange to you, but the strange thing is that this doll was never made to be sold in Italy, and there's no reason why this doll should speak Italian, according to the manufacturers. So we've actually got Giancarlo. Buongiorno.
Come sta oggi? Questa mattina. Bene.
Italiano. Oh, shut up.
An Italian waiter, and he's a typical Italian. I tell you, look.
Sì, molto bene.
No, first okay. Don't stand up.
Now tell us what he is saying, then, Giancarlo.
Cosa ha detto? Un minuto.
Ok, press it again.
Buzz Lightyear alla riscossa.
E questo dice Buzz Lightyear alla riscossa. La riscossa means Buzz Lightyear is on the attack.
He's on the attack.
Ok. Strange name, Buzz Lightyear.
I'll just do one more thing.
Oh, un'altra cosa. Va verso l'infinito e oltre. That means beyond the sky and... beyond the stars and the universe, you know. Oh, it's very
right.
Good.
You're
doing very well. Hold on, there must be something else.
Buzz Lightyear.
Ah, it's just repeating.
Io sono Buzz Lightyear. I am Buzz Lightyear.
I got that one.
What a silly name.
In Italian,
you can't translate.
Sono Buzz Lightyear.
Hold on. Ah, that's nice. You see, you're going to impartial, I come in peace. So after all the wars and all the things, now he's in peace.
He comes in peace?
Yes.
This is a doll that speaks Italian, and apparently they never made one that speaks Italian. Where did he come from?
That'll be worth a fortune one day, won't it?
If you have any stories a bit like that, anything you've bought, a toy or something, you've got it home and there's been something quite strange about it, do let us know. We want to hear. So write to us at the Big
Two Lockers Cottages. Oh, for London 8-3-2-N-N.
But now, everyone's incredibly excited because it's time to play our brand new competition. Oh dear,
what can the chatter be?
Is 0891-4-7-4. But right now, it's time to shout, where are you, Keith?
Yay, I'm just by the fireside, keeping warm with Cathy Dennis! Hey! Reportedly, I remember reading the paper that you're one of the richest ladies in the world. Is this true?
It's not true.
No, come on, I read it in the papers. It must be true. Because you made a lot of money in the States, didn't you?
Oh, God. That's not one of your questions.
I don't care about these briefs. They can go out the window. I want to find out about you. There's more coming up in a minute. But, I mean, you have got a lot of dosh. Come on, I knocked on your front door and went round to your house. It's beautiful. It really is.
Well, thank you.
You've been a bit cagey about the financial side of things.
Well, I don't know.
Well, no, it's nice to know, you see, because, like, in 1987, I mean, it was reported that you made, what was it, £2 million from the charts over in the States. Did the sort of money and the sort of fame and fortune change you in any way, shape or form?
No, I don't think so. I'd like to think I'm the same person. I've still got most of the same friends.
Yeah. But was it difficult to sort of cope with and sort of take on board all this money and all this fame and fortune?
I never said I had all this money.
I'm conning you too. Because you came from sort of like, not a humble background, but sort of a slightly not so extravagant background, didn't you? Because your family were in the business.
Yeah, they were musicians for a long time, 20 years.
Right.
So I just followed on from them, really.
What was the name of their band that they used to sort of...
Well, it had various names, but it was probably for the longest time it was the Alan Dennis Band.
Right. And did you actually perform with them?
Yes, I did.
Right. How old were you then?
I started at 13.
Right.
I was quite young.
And did you ever think you'd sort of reach such climbs in such a short period of time, within 10 years?
Not really, no. I didn't know. Because then I, when I was doing the singing with my dad, I was actually an insurance clerk at the same time.
Oh, you were working with it?
Yeah, when I left school. So
how did the music thing come about then? I mean, how did you sort of like break that sort of normal mould of sort of like appearing in clubs and singing with your dad? How did the record thing come about? Was it your dad being pushy or...?
No, actually, it was the other way around. I was very lucky and I found a manager who really believed in me and is, well, very good at his job.
How did you go about finding these guys then? Because you hear about sort of like people talking about their managers. I mean, where do these people come from?
I don't know. I think it really is a talent to be a manager because you have to be very good at understanding the artist and I think you're very lucky if you can find a manager who has long-term views rather than just this short-term, let's get a hit, you know, because I've always wanted to have a long career, so.
Talk about a long career, you've taken 2 years off though, haven't you?
Actually, three.
Why?
I've been writing my next album and it's taken a long time because it's evolved from into something quite different from the dance music I was doing before and hopefully I think I've got it right now.
Has having a recording studio in your house sort of helped things just a little bit, or has that made you lazy because you think it's there, you know, that I'll do it any time I like?
No, I think it makes it a lot easier. I mean, I don't do everything there, but I do a fair bit there. It's nice, you can just get up in the morning and you know,
do you still make a lot of noise in your house because there's a big complaint about your neighbours?
That was a load of
the
rubbish.
The noisy Cathy Dennis.
That was a load of rubbish.
Was it?
That story was complete rubbish.
There was no complaints whatsoever?
No, it's a really long story.
You're being really cagey this morning. All right, well, we can put you on the spot right now because you were in Beverly Hills 90210, weren't you?
Yes.
That's wonderful acting and performance. Just take a look at this.
Okay, let's hear it again for the class of 93. Never thought you'd make it, did you? But you did. Well, we're all here. I guess it's time to make some memories.
Friends is one, the friend that brought you to my life. So long.
laughing there because you used to work in holiday camps, didn't you? Did that take you back to the days of that?
It's kind of similar, yeah. Right. Yeah, it sounds the same, actually.
Would you like some more sort of like acting-y, bitty typey things?
Yeah, I think if something interesting came along, I would be interested.
Mm. Okay, some tough questions for you now, because I've been reading about you in the paper. What's your best feature?
I think my toenails.
Your toenails? Why your toenails?
Just because they look quite nice.
Okay, can I have a little look at the toenails, please? Thank you very much. Okay, what's your worst feature?
Worst feature? Well, I would say my... I don't know if I want to draw attention to...
Go on, whisper to me. Your bum. Right, okay. You can't get away with anything here, I can tell you that. Oh, what's all this? I mean, you've got a lovely bottom. I mean, not that I'd love to. But I will later. But you keep fit, don't you? You do a lot of exercise.
I try to, yeah.
Yeah, what do you do?
I do a lot of dance classes.
Right.
I like running. I like weights. I like swimming.
And is it true, I'm reading in the papers, that you say you always stay in a hotel with a gym? Or is that just the usual sort of rubbish that we hear?
No, that is true.
Okay.
I don't always use it.
All right, well, we should have a little workout now. Chris, I've got to ask you, album, when's the album coming out?
Well, I'm not quite sure when the album's due out. It will be before the end of the year, and the single probably will be hopefully the end of May, if it doesn't get
all right. Cathy, you're a real star. Thank you very much. Cathy Dennis! Lovely. Question about the clip and the card's the wrong way.
Which is where I work from, and we teach various divinatory arts here to a high level of perfection, including the tarot, astrology, and also this practice as well.
Well, let's move you on a bit, because Cathy has been willing to reveal all. This is her favourite feature of feet, especially her toes there. So let's have a look at
Cathy. Oh, the angle. Sorry.
Are you ticklish as well?
Yes, I am.
Very interesting. As you'll see here, from a very highly pronounced toe of Jupiter, this shows an ability to charm people and to win people in positions of power and authority. It shows tremendous... if I check underneath, it shows tremendous good luck, but usually in later life. The very small toe of Mercury here does touch upon the fact that this person is very self-doubting and doesn't see her own qualities in the way that most other people would easily find them immensely visible.
Hey, that could be why you've had 3 years off. Do you know what I mean? Because you're a bit sort of, you are a little bit sort of doubting at the moment, aren't you?
Not anymore. I was. I probably have had a period of that.
Mm. Yeah. If I just check the line underneath here, which is the mounds. I'm checking the mounds here. There's the fleshy parts. This is the second aspect of this particular divinatory art. The mounds here, that's interesting. The very strong sensation beneath the toe of Apollo represents, it symbolises that this person will become immensely famous, but later on in life, as I said earlier, it relates to the other influence I've picked up
here. And what about sexuality? No, I just want
to... Okay.
It's not as pronounced, it's certainly not as pronounced as in your feet, Keith, but...
You just can't compete.
In fact, that very word is relevant here, because this person would have doubts about their level of performance, and there's a need to relax on that and just to enjoy yourself much more rather than to worry whether you're living up to somebody else's expectations or fantasies. So,
Terry, for the moment,
great.
Thank you very much.
You're
that's
very welcome.
Fascinating, really is. You can tell your future in your feet, you see, and this man will tell you not to be defeated. I just threw that in. Okay, we should be light on our toes very shortly because we've got a brand new competition. Yes. Old dear, what could the chatter be?
Delicate boys, you knew the surnames, but what were the first names of those two top cops? Ken Hutch and Dave Starsky. Ken! I couldn't believe that. His name was Ken. I think that's hilarious. And now the clip from Starsky and Hutch, which is on the Bravo channel tonight at 9 p.m. Classic 70s stuff there. Now, you may be wondering why we've got all the girls gathered in the hall here. Because, I'll tell you, it's time to play...
Ten Pals in Their Pants.
Yes. A brand new part of the show, The Big Breakfast. Have your pens and papers handy every day this week, because we'll be offering you the chance to make an exciting new pen pal. Today's pen pal is exciting, gorgeous, and you'll see he has a lot to offer. So without further ado...
It's time to meet today's pen pals in their pants.
Pal is Spencer. He's 25 years old. He's 6'2" with eyes of blue. His favourite film was About Last Night.
His favourite woman is Michelle Pfeiffer, and he's into windsurfing, skiing and tennis. And he's very brave there, standing in his pants there. Now, girls, what do you think? Everyone impressed?
No.
Not at all? Okay. And now, can you come a bit closer so we can have a bit of a closer look? What's your best feature?
All of it.
Right here.
Oh, my God. Well, that's a matter of opinion. Now, if you would like to be Spencer's pen pal, okay, and what kind of woman are you looking for, Spencer?
Tall blonde.
Okay, then write to us at our usual address, which of course is 2 Lockheed for 52. Notice. And of course, you could also nominate someone. And I'll leave you girls now. Cathy, you're in charge. You can all get to know Spencer.
Yeah, we've had a cracky morning this morning.
Coming up on tomorrow's show, Lily, our Oscars correspondent, and live from Hollywood. That'd be fantastic. Also, the full inside story of the Oscars in Snap, Crackle and Pop. And we meet the famous 5. You'd be mad.
Great. Thanks to everybody this morning. But a special thank you to this lady here, Cathy Dennis. It's her birthday today. And you're 27, I'm right in saying?
Yes.
We've got a little treat for you. Look, because you've got a
birthday, birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Hey, Toby, you didn't like them. They blew out, please. Pretend to blow them. Pretend. Yeah!